bother you? It's fun.
I know, I wasn't really understanding the problem about glucose and lactose levels being low at the end of the lecture.
Oh, yes, that is a tricky one. Well, I have a blackboard here in the tennis court. Let's go take a look at it.
Come on, let's go.
How is the Lac Operon going to be regulated? Let's deal with the glucose levels low. Glucose levels low mean what for cyclic AMP?
It's got to be high, right?
Right. So that means high levels of cyclic AMP. Which means that cyclic AMP bind, so cyclic AMP along with CAP are going to bind in front of the promoter sequence, the landing lights are on, and you are ready for transcription. Except, lactose levels are low. If lactose levels are low, the repressor looks in this configuration. This repressor is going to bind to the operator sequence and will prevent the RNA polymerase from transcribing. So the answer to this one is no, Lac Z, Y, or A transcription. Got it?
Got it.
Okay, this time I'll play you left-handed. I'm actually a left-hander.
Oh,
let's go
really?
Try it.
Okay. All right, sounds good.